I'm going to make a crab and pineapple tartare. Tartare sounds quite fancy, doesn't it? But literally, it is some tinned pineapple and a tin of crab. I haven't seen tinned pineapple for ages, but I used to love these rings. I mean, look at that. They're just these perfect, like, rings you can look through. Really retro, but fun. I'm gonna add a few extra flavors. One of them is some lime, and that lime gives it that kind of tropical feel, which we want. When you're juicing citrus fruit, you want to roll it beforehand on a board because that will release all the juices. It means when you squeeze it, you get the best out of it. Now, before I squeeze it, I'm gonna zest half of it. Just want about a teaspoon of lime zest. I always get transported to some tropical island when I smell fresh lime zest. Add my crab meat. Check you're buying the crab meat from a sustainable source. Usually has it labeled on the tin. So I've drained off the crab meat and it's a mix of brown and white meat. So it's already flaked in there. I'm just gonna add that. Chop the pineapple into chunks.
Add the chopped pineapple to the 80 grams of crab meat. Next, add a finely diced shallot.
Give it a little stir through. You want to get everything intermingled. I always find a little bit of acidity lifts and enlivens dishes. So give it a little squeeze.
Along with the juice of half a lime, a generous pinch of salt.
One whole cucumber, you're gonna slice it into slices about half a centimetre thick, and then into strips, and then into cubes. The crab and pineapple tartare is actually finished. You could just serve it as it is, but I'm gonna show you three fun ways to have it as a starter or as an aperitif. One way of serving it is with a humble piece of sliced bread. You might think, oh, sliced bread, not very exciting. Well, add a little bit of butter. Then I'm using a cookie cutter.
The leftover bread can be blitzed into crumbs and frozen for another day.
Now, I think this is getting nice and hot, so I'll put my rounds in. Got that satisfying sizzle. So it literally needs a couple of minutes on each side so you get that nice caramelization and the butter melts into the bread. This is a simple way of upgrading your humble slice of bread. Also a good thing to know when you need a bread base for a starter, you need it to look a little bit more sophisticated, just use a cookie cutter. Okay, so we've got crispiness on both sides. Nice bit of caramelization. So if I was serving this as a starter, you can do it a bit like this. Help you so you don't make a mess. Yes! You get a nice round shape. And to finish it off, I'm just gonna add a few fronds of dill. You could use some parsley if you don't have dill.
And finally, a drizzle of olive oil. My vegetable cannelloni combines strong Mediterranean flavours from a few jars with some more familiar ingredients.
I'm going to start off by making a simple tomato sauce, which is literally some cherry tomatoes and a bit of olive oil. I'm going to cut them in half.
I'm using 500 grams of sweet ripe cherry tomatoes and a good splash of olive oil. On a medium heat, the tomatoes will burst and go mushy in around 8 minutes.
This is a super speedy tomato sauce, not much to it. For my cannelloni, I'm kind of capturing all the flavours of the south of France here. You know, you've got courgettes, you've got grilled peppers, you've got the artichoke, the tapenade. These are all flavours which I think are really Mediterranean, super summery. So you're gonna make these ribbons. It's quite flexible because you're gonna have to roll it up. So if it's too thick, then you won't be able to roll it up. Now I've got some grilled peppers, and grilled peppers, when you buy them in the jar, they're literally They've done all the hard work for you, but what they've done is they've popped it on the grill and blackened the skin and then peeled the skin off. The peppers have a lovely smoky flavour from the grilling and real sweetness to them, so they're packed full of flavour. Look at those colours. You've got the bright green, the red. It's like summer holidays.
Next, artichoke hearts from a jar. Again, the hard work is already done.
They've peeled off, you know, the tough outer leaves, and all you're left are with these tender hearts. You have it in the back of your cupboard, ready to go when you need it.
200 grams of artichokes and 200 grams of peppers will be plenty.
Tomato sauce is done. You can see the tomatoes have broken down and have become mushy. You can just squash them a little bit. I'm going to assemble my cannelloni. To start off with some lasagna sheets. These are fresh ones. If you can't get hold of fresh ones, you could use dried ones. You'd have to cook them. So you just get that kind of flexible texture. And here I've got some black olive tapenade paste, and you just spread it on. And then you're gonna add a courgette. It's just about building those layers, like you do for lasagna, really. We're gonna take some peppers. And then finally, add some of that lovely rich tomato sauce. Just a little bit in the middle. Gently pull it all together like so, and then pop it into our baking dish with the fold at the bottom. Roll and repeat. So make sure they're tucked in tightly together. All right, look, they all look so snug, tucked into that tray. The rest of the tomato sauce, I'm gonna pop on top. Nothing's going to waste. Now to that, I'm gonna add one of my favorite ingredients, creme fraiche. Just dollop a little bit on. Right, creme fraiche on. And then a tad of black pepper on the top. So that's gonna go into a preheated oven at 180 degrees fan for about half an hour. You want all that bubbly, kind of golden ooziness happening, and then you know it's ready.
The cannelloni has been baking for 30 minutes.
That smells so good. Now, before we serve it, there are a few little finishing touches. I like to add some lemon zest on top. And then a pop of green, some parsley. It was a nice fresh touch to the dish. One last thing, a drizzle of olive oil. We're getting all the flavours of the Mediterranean here. Look at that. See all the veg in the middle? It's all kind of melded into each other. You can serve this with a nice fresh green salad. I've just got some salad leaves here, a bit of rocket, a bit of spinach. You don't need much else. Just a little bit on the side. I'm gonna add a squeeze of lemon to that. All those flavors of the Mediterranean with the artichoke, the grilled peppers, the tapenade. It's like going on holiday without leaving your kitchen.